Hey friends, welcome. So after so many requests about Lucky Bamboo, I have thought of making a video about it. Well, you can see that my Lucky Bamboo is so lush and green. So in this video, I would be telling you about what tips and tricks I follow to keep my Lucky Bamboo green and what tricks you should follow so that you can avoid the Lucky Bamboo turning yellow. And you can also grow a very lush green Lucky Bamboo like this. So let's talk about the temperature of Lucky Bamboo. So Lucky Bamboo cannot sustain harsh temperature, whether it is harsh summer or harsh cold. So you have to make sure that in summers you avoid giving the direct sunlight or giving the extreme bright light to Lucky Bamboo, and in winters you can keep it in indirect sunlight. So the second thing is position. The position is very important for Lucky Bamboo. So we all think that Lucky Bamboo is an indoor plant and we keep it in dark rooms. But we have to make sure that Lucky Bamboo should get at least 7 to 8 hours of artificial light. Then only it will grow, otherwise this leaf starts turning yellow. So the second thing about Lucky Bamboo is its water. So it's very important what kind of water do we keep Lucky Bamboo. Generally we use the tap water, which we shouldn't use. So tap water has a lot of fluorides and chlorine, which harms the stem of Lucky Bamboo. So make sure the water you put in Lucky Bamboo is the water you drink, so that your Lucky Bamboo would be safe. And also we have to keep changing the water in every 3 days, because if we don't change the water, the bacteria grows and then it harms the Lucky Bamboo. The next thing in Lucky Bamboo you have to make sure are its roots and the stems. So we see that day by day some of the stems get yellow in Lucky Bamboo. So you have to make sure if one stem has become yellow in Lucky Bamboo, you have to remove the stem. Otherwise the bacterial infection grows and it makes the other stem also yellow. So whenever you find a stem which is rotten or yellow, please remove the stem outside the Lucky Bamboo and throw it. Because the rotten stem also rots the whole plant. So you have to make sure that you remove the yellow rotten stems of the Lucky Bamboo from the plant. So you can better understand this in this way, like one rotten apple can make the other apples also rot. So like that, this stem can also rot the other stems. So you have to make sure that one bamboo shoot, whenever it is having any bacterial infection, you have to immediately remove that stem. So the most important thing which we forget about Lucky Bamboo is that we grow it in water, and the plants which we grow in water are very susceptible to bacterial infection. So we always have to treat its roots so that the roots never gets the bacterial infection. So here I am using the cinnamon stick. So what I do is I always put a cinnamon stick in the water so that the roots doesn't get bacteria. So I use the whole cinnamon stick. You can even use the cinnamon powder. What you can do is you can just sprinkle little bit of cinnamon powder in the pot wherever you keep Lucky Bamboo, and that will avoid the bacterial infection which develops in the Lucky Bamboo, and that way the roots will be very healthy and the bacteria won't grow in Lucky Bamboo. And you have to know that the bacterial infection in Lucky Bamboo starts from its roots only. So you have to do this. So that's it. Thank you so much.